River Birch, Betula nigra. This is a Native American birch that grows very well in the eastern half of the United States. It has a wide range all the way from basically the Mississippi River and Illinois, southeast into the Carolinas and north, even into Connecticut, it's native. It's a great plant for the home landscape. It's a small tree. It will grow slowly over time to 60 feet. There have been trees as tall as 100 feet in the wild, but it's generally much smaller than that. River birch, as its name implies, prefers plenty of moisture around its feet, but it's very tolerant. It will also grow in the upland situations in sort of dry ground, but where we've got this one growing here at the gardens is basically at the top of a spring that comes out of the ground here that I'm standing over. You can see that the ground is very wet. There's water, standing water, that the honeybees are actually coming to forage around. There's a honeybee right now. There are several wonderful qualities about river birch that make it worth growing. The first one is it's a native tree and is resistant to the pests of other birches, the paper bark birch and the European paper bark birch. All are susceptible to the bronze birch borer, a serious pest that bores into the tree and causes mortality. These are resistant to the bronze birch borer, yet if you choose your variety correctly, you can get a wonderful, almost white or very light colored bark. And this exfoliating bark is a natural part of the tree's growth. They call this exfoliating because it comes off of the tree. And you can use this actually as a sort of paper. I guess you could harvest the berries from a pokeberry, make a little ink from that, and write on the paper bark birch, and you have a native note. Another aspect of the plant is it has a nice yellow fall color that stays active for maybe a week to 10 days in late October, early November. River birch, along with all the other birches, are in their own family, Betulaceae, the birch family. The first peoples used the sap from this tree as a sweetener, a lot, it's very similar to the sugar maple syrup that we think of today. They didn't boil it down, but the sap was used as a sweetener. The inner bark was also used for many purposes. It's really too much of a knotty wood for much commercial use of the wood. You can grow river birch as a single trunked specimen like we have here, or as a multi-trunked specimen. It's great in the native woodland garden. It likes partial shade, but it will tolerate full sun with plenty of water. For fall and winter interest, with the fall color and the wonderful light-colored bark, this is a wonderful native tree, resistant to many of the pests that the other paper barks succumb to. River birch.